guys, how are you? So in today's session, we are going to talk about assumptions of linear regression. So when we are going to talk about the linear regression algorithm, where we have to fit our linear regression model, trying to fit our model for the data which is linear, we have some assumptions before fitting our model in our data sets. And in today's session, we are just go through from these assumptions, like what are the assumptions that we assume before fitting our model in our data, what are those assumptions, and let's start with this. So first of all, so linear relationship between the features and the target. The first assumption that we are make in our data is that the data which we have is the linear relationship between the features and the target. If you plot the features and the target in a 2D plot, then you can see the linear graph between them. You have to see the linear graph. Like, you don't see something like exponential or the tan graph. Like, you have to see the linear graph. This is the first assumption. Like, according to this assumption, there is a linear relationship between the features and the target. Linear regression captures only linear relationship. This is can be valid by plotting a scatter plot between the features and the target. So how to identify this linear relationship? First, you have to do the scatter plot between the sales or the TV advertisement, or these are just names. You can do the scatter plot for the features and the target, and to figure out that there is the linear relationship between features and the target or not. And if it is valid, then you can go to the next step. Like, this is the assumption for doing the linear regression or to fit the linear regression model in our data. So next is little or no multicollinearity between the features. Multicollinearity is a state of very high intercorrelations and interassociations among the independent variables. It is therefore a type of disturbance in the data it presents, weakens the statistical power of the regression model. Pair plots and heat map correlation metrics can be used for identifying high correlated features. So here it says that if you have multiple features, like you have 3 input features, 2 input features, or more than 2 input features, then you have to figure out that if there is any correlation between those features or not. If there have a correlation, then you can't use the linear regression because it weakens the statistical power of the regression model. There is assumption that all other features are independent to each other. So this is the second assumption for the linear regression, that if you are going to apply the linear regression in your data, then this is the second assumption for that. And this is the like graph where, as you can see, there is a relationship between TV and TV, radio and radio, newspaper and newspaper. That's quite obvious that yes, TV is related with its own data. But as you can see, TV is not related to a radio, TV is not related to newspaper, and thus we can use this data for doing the linear regression because there is no correlation, there is no any dependency between those input features. So there is no correlation, so that's why we can use the linear regression model on this data. I mean, that's the third assumption. And this is the fourth assumption, where we have to see the homoscedasticity assumption. Homoscedasticity describes a situation in which the error term, that is the noise or random disturbance in the relationship between the features and the target, is the same across the values of the independent variable. A scatter plot for the residual values and the predicted values is good way to check for homoscedasticity. There should be no clear pattern in the disturbance, and if there is a specific pattern, the data is heteroscedastic. So basically, it wants to say that let me show you the graph for this. Yes, as you can see, our data is like linear. As you can see, the outliers for this point is this in this much range, and the outliers for this point data, this point data is also at this much range. The data is uniformly distributed. All of the data is uniformly distributed. There is no disturbance in the data. But as you can see, first of all, the data is scattered, then it is converged, and then it is again scattered. And as you can see, the data is going to converge. The data is going to converge at a point. So these two are the heteroscedasticity. These two data set are heteroscedastic, and this data is homoscedastic. So to do the linear regression, it has one or more assumption, which is the date, which is this, like your data should be homoscedastic, not the heteroscedastic. But if your data is heteroscedastic, you don't use linear regression model for your data. You have to use any other model to get the prediction, but you can't use the linear regression model if the data is heteroscedastic. You can only use your model for only homoscedastic data. Next is normal distribution of error terms. The fourth assumption is that the error residuals follow a normal distribution. However, a less widely known fact is that a sample sizes increases the normality assumption for the residuals is not needed. More precisely, if we consider repeated sampling from our population for large sample sizes, the distribution across repeated samples of the ordinary least square estimates the regression coefficients follow a normal distribution. A consequence of for moderate to large sample sizes, non-normality of residuals should not adversely affect the usual inferential procedures. This result is consequence of an extremely important result in statistics known as central limit theorem. So basically, the fourth assumption is it is like normal distribution, where you can say that a less widely known fact is that a sample size increases the normality assumption for the residual, which is not needed. So we are considering, like, if we have the sample of our population from large sample sizes, the distribution should be across all the area. The distribution across repeated samples of the ordinary least square estimates the regression coefficient follow a normal distribution. The data you are going to take for the population data set should be normally distributed. It's not like you get the data from a single point only. You have to take data from all the sides. So that's about the normal distribution of error terms. Next is like little or no autocorrelation in the residuals. Autocorrelation occurs when the residual occurs are dependent on each other. The presence of correlation in error terms drastically reduces model's accuracy. This usually occurs in time series models, where the next instance is depend on the previous instant. Autocorrelation can be tested with the help of Durbin-Watson test. The null hypothesis of the test is that there is no serial correlation. So basically, in autocorrelation, like, you get the output for the first row, and while you are getting the output of the second row, that output of second row should be depend on the first row. It is known as autocorrelation. And while you are using the linear regression model on your data set, it is an assumption that there is no autocorrelation. Like, the previous output should not affect the next output, and the next output should not be affected by the previous output. The next output should not be dependent on the previous output. So this is the last and the fifth assumption for this linear regression algorithm. And if these assumptions fail, then you can't, if any one of these assumptions from these five assumptions fails, then you can't use the linear regression model. Then you can't use the linear regression model. But if any, but all of these assumptions are satisfied, then you can use the linear regression model easily. And that's all about the assumptions on all here. We talk about the five assumptions. If I repeat, like first we see that there is linear relationship between the features and the target. Next, we see the multicollinearity between the features. There is nothing correlation between the features. All features are should be independent and not dependent on each other, not correlated to each other. And next, we see that the homoscedasticity assumption, that like our data is the homoscedastic, not the heteroscedastic. All the data is uniformly distributed. There is no shaping in the data. If the data is not uniformly distributed, then we can't use this data. Then we can't use the linear regression for fitting for this data. If the data is homoscedastic, then we can use the linear regression for fit on this data. And next we talk about the normal distribution of errors, and at last we talk about the no autocorrelation. That means there is no autocorrelation between the outputs. The previous output should not affect the next. The previous output should not affect the next output, and the next output should not be affected by the previous output. So that's all about the assumptions of the linear regressions. These are the five assumptions of the linear regression, and I hope I just clear all your doubts and get you and told you about and teach you about the basics of the assumptions of the linear regressions, or tell you about the assumptions of the linear regression model. So that's all about the today's session. Thank you. Bye bye. Take care. Stay motivated and keep learning.